let's take a real quick look at exponents, and then we'll look at multiplying the same base that have exponents, and then we're going to look at dividing exponents. So we need to learn how to multiply terms that have exponents and also to divide terms that have exponents. First, what is an exponent? Well, the base number, which is in this first example 2 is our base, is multiplied the number of times the exponent, which is 3. So an exponent tells us to multiply 2 3 times. In this one, 2 times 2 times 2 would be another way of writing it. In our second example, negative 3 to the power of 6 is going to tell us they want us to multiply everything that's in parentheses times 6 times. Well, that includes the negative because the negative is in parentheses, so we would say negative 3 times 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 negative 3. 6 negatives multiplied together is an even number, so we know we're going to have a positive answer. And 3 times 3 times 3 is going to give us, or 3 times 3 will give us 9, and I'd multiply that 3 times, I'd end up with 9 cubed. Actually, I think your answer here is going to be 729. But that's not as important as knowing what we do with that negative. What we have to remember is that when the negative is included in parentheses, it is raised to the exponent. If it's not included in the parentheses, it is not considered a part of the exponent. It's just stuck out front. For 5x squared, the only thing that is squared in this problem is the x value. The 5 is just in front, multiplied times it, which is different from our second example. In the second example, what we're really saying is 5x times 5x. Notice everything in parentheses is squared. Now I would multiply those together, and we'll do that in just a minute. But that's what this means, is the exponent notation is really important where the parentheses are. If the exponent is outside of the parentheses, everything inside parentheses is raised to that power, whatever it is. Look at example 1. Inside parentheses, I have a negative 3, and it's raised to the power of 2. That's the same as saying negative 3 multiplied 2 times. So I have 2 negatives, which gives me a positive 9. Example 2 is different. It does not have the negative included in parentheses. The only thing raised to the power of 2 is the number 3. The negative is simply out in front of the 3. So what do we say? We say it's a negative 3 times 3, which would be a negative 9. We make a difference in a 9 and a negative 9. Look at example number 3. With fractions, we're going to say the negative 1/9 times another negative 1/9. Well, 2 negatives, even number, we're going to have a positive answer. What do? We multiply numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. Our answer is 1 over 81. And example 4 shows us we're going to multiply negative 4 times, and I'm going to say 3 cubed, which is 3 times 3 times 3. Now, if I cubed 3, I know that that answer is going to be 27. And 4 times, or negative 4 times 27 is going to give me a negative 108. So, how do we easily add or multiply bases, the same base that has an exponent? We don't want to have to figure out what the actual number is. We just want to keep it in exponential notation. For example, 5, we have negative 5 as our base, and it's the same in both of those numbers. One time it's raised to the power of 7, and the next to the power of 6, and these are multiplied times each other. So when we say negative 5 to the power of 7 times negative 5 to the power of 6, what we do is add exponents. What we end up with is negative 5 to the power of 7 plus 6. In other words, we would have negative 5 to the power of 13. Well, remember, we're multiplying numbers that have the same base, and we add the exponents. Look at example 2. First, we have to figure what is being raised to the power of the exponents. Well, it's only the z in each of the terms, or the numbers. So we're going to take these negative 2 coefficients and we're going to multiply them first. Negative 2 times negative 2 gives us a positive 4. And then we say z cubed times z squared is z to the power of 3 plus 2, or 5. In example 7, we have no coefficient, no numbers to multiply, so we just have to be concerned with the variables. Let's take the a terms. A squared times a to the power of 13, let's add the exponents, we get a to the power of 15, times b times b to the 17th. Now b with no exponent is really understood exponent of 1, so we add 1 plus 17 and we get b to the power of 18. Okay, example 8, we do have a coefficient. We take care of coefficients. They're the numbers in front of the variables first. We're going to say 12 times a negative 1. Remember, if there's no 1, if there's no number, it's considered 1. Times a negative 1 would give us a negative 12. Times a positive 1 would give us still a negative 12. So our coefficient is going to be negative 12. Now let's do x terms. X squared, x to the power of 6, x to the 4th. Add exponents. 2 plus 6 is 8. Plus 4, I'm going to have x to the power of 12. Next, we need to learn to multiply exponents when we are raising a term with an exponent to another power. In other words, I have x to the power of 7, and that is being raised, that entire term is being raised to the power of 5. When that's happening, it's multiplication. That is x to the power of 7 times 5. In other words, x to the power of 35. Let's look at another one. This one is a fraction, and each of the terms is being raised to that exponent. We're saying x to the power of 1, y to the power of 1, and they would both be raised to the power of 2 over 7 raised to the power of 2. Remember, we do the same thing to the numerator that we do to the denominator when the fraction is included in parentheses. So now I can look at each of them separately. X to the power of 1 times 2 is x to the power of 2. Y to the power of 1 times 2 is y to the power of 2. And it's over 7 squared, which I know that one, so I'll go ahead and resolve it. It's 49. Next, we divide. When we divide the same base, they have the same base. Notice they're both y's, and it's division. They both have exponents. We subtract the exponents. Now, I'm going to say 10 minus 9 gives me y to the power of 1. Where do I leave it? I leave it in the part of the fraction that had the largest exponent. So I have y to the 1. In the denominator, I just have 1 because all of those disappeared. They were subtracted away. And this is really just plain y. Let's look at example 12. Let's see if we can say subtract these exponents. We have x to the 8th over x to the 1st, or what, power of 1. We would say x to the 8 minus 1 is going to give us x to the power of 7. We're going to leave it in the numerator of our fraction because that's where the larger exponent was. Let's take care of the y terms, or the y variable. We say y to the 6th over y to the 5th. Y to the 6 minus 5 is going to give us y to the power of 1, or just y. I'm also going to leave it in the numerator because that's where my larger exponent was. And in the denominator, there's nothing left. I've taken care of both the x and y variables. It's just a 1. So this is really x to the power of 7, y. Now, one more thing we need to know in example 13 and 14 is that anything with an exponent of 0 is equal to 1. So 23 to the power of 0 would equal 1. If I said 5 million to the power of 0, it would also be just equal to the number 1. What about example 14? I have negative 2x to 0. Remember, the only thing that's being raised to that exponent is the x. So negative 2 has nothing to do with it. It's just stuck out there multiplied times x to the power of 0, which is 1. So my answer would be negative 2.